Hello everybody, it's Thursday morning, about 7:30 a.m. And as you can see, I'm at my world famous laundromat. Whoa! And the phone just flipped off the laundry cart. I got it sitting on a chrome rod here to keep it steady. I'm at Northern and 19th Avenue Community. And there's a new remodeled laundromat here that I come to weekly. Doing two loads for all the information that you don't need. 1611 out of my pocket Bible, my skinny book. I make skinny books. I take the New Testament only and the 14 letters of Paul. And I re-glue the back binding and I make a skinny book. Because that's all you really need to know is Paul was the number one writer of New Testament scripture. We're in the New Covenant. We're in the New Testament. So learn his letters and learn the last six. Because he can look back at 35 years of Judaism or 25 years of Judaism and 25 years of Christianity that the Holy Spirit started through him. The Holy Spirit called him and taught him. Same way with me. At 30 years old, the Lord called me and taught me 45 years, and here I am standing in the laundromat trying to relay truth to you. Now, the problem is me flesh. Me flesh is the number one problem. And you flesh, me flesh, us flesh. Flesh opposes the will of the Spirit. The flesh is contrary to the Spirit. The number one problem is flesh, humanity, flesh. The number one spiritual enemy is Satan. And there is a scripture that the church doesn't understand. Oh, it's not. We don't battle against flesh and blood. It's a spiritual warfare out of Ephesians. Yes, we do. The spiritual warfare is through Antichrist false teachers, the flesh, just like it's the Holy Spirit to us who are born and believe. The flesh is always in the program. The flesh is the problem. If we could get our will, old nature, whoops, that's twice, will, old nature, and habits out of the way, we could move in the power of the Spirit. But our flesh is contrary to the Spirit and in the way. That is the truth of things, okay? Now, here's something that bothers me. Men, I'm having trouble with this, and it'll probably blink out on me if I put my fingers in the wrong place. I meet with 12 to 17 loving brethren on Wednesday morning, 6 a.m. in the morning. They're studying Mark. They're studying the place where the man with the withered hand is in the temple, and the Lord asks him, Is it okay to do good or to do evil on the Sabbath? And he gets no answer. So he calls them forth and he shows his love, his spirit power, and speaks. And the man's hand, the natural, is touched. The man's hand is made normal or whole. Now he's speaking to human flesh problem. The Sadducees, the Pharisees, the priesthood, the scribes, the Herodians, those that follow Herod, okay? And they're not spiritual men. So what do the men in the Bible study start to do? They start to show their human intellect, all right, of Scripture, their memory of Scripture. And the first thing they do, well, was this a setup? Did the Sadducees and Pharisees bring the man with the withered hand in to test the Lord? Or did the Lord send him in ahead of time and the Lord had one up on him and healed the hand, showed his power and authority? The Bible doesn't say that. So why are we waging word battles or thinking or understanding? Let's stay with what the word says, makes clear over and over again. And the question was, is it okay to do good or to do evil on the Sabbath? And then it gets over to the devil casting out demons. They call him Beelzebub, prince of the darkness, prince of demons.
And he says, how can Satan cast out Satan? If a house be divided against itself, it can't stand, whether it's a good house or a bad house. And flesh is the problem. Man's intellect, Judaism. You know, they got into greater debates over their rabbis, their teachers, and their writings, the oral law of the Jews, the Talmud, and different theologies from different teachers and writers, more than they did faith in God. That's what started it all, faith in Abraham. And from it would come the singular seed, the Lord Jesus Christ. And if you're born of that singular seed, then you have Christ in you, the hope of glory. That is the mystery. And I ask them, what is the gospel? And they say, well, Jesus is the... No, it's a gospel of peace is what the word says. The good news of peace within. And the mystery is Christ within. And if you're born of the Spirit and have Christ within, you have hope and of inheritance in heaven, in a new Jerusalem, a heavenly kingdom, an inheritance, a joint heir, being with the Lord where he is and beholding his glory. Did you get all that? But man has to show off. The problem is the flesh. You're carnal, babes with envy, strife, and division. Carnal, couldn't even teach you a spiritual. You're on the milk of the word. You can't even think spiritual. That's what Paul told the Corinthians in 1 Corinthians. That there was envy, strife, and division, and they were carnal babes on the milk of the word. They didn't accurately handle or rightly divide the word of truth. And you get into word battles. Is that the correct word? What does that word mean? And then you start to do conjectures. Well, what if? Well, was he a set up by the Lord or a set up by the Sadducees? The word doesn't say. If the word doesn't say, don't go there. Get the flesh out of the way. Follow truth in the word. Follow the Spirit. Follow the witness of the Spirit over the word. And the word does not imply. The word makes clear through the simple rule of repetition. Twos, threes, and fours. Well, we got people coming into the laundromat there to do their wash. I made a frustrated point today. Didn't even get to reading the scriptures. And I was going to read, if the phone doesn't flip for the fourth time, 1 Timothy 6, 3, I think, through 6. Read 1 Timothy 6, 3 through 6, and you'll get what I'm saying here. All right, you have a great day. B periods Eugene Bear saying bye. Wow. That may not even be all on here. Where did it stop? How was it healed?